Hello friends, in this video I will be helping you the principal component analysis, then I will be coming to its 2D as well as 3D example. I will be just explaining you why we actually use it in 2D as well as 3D, then I will be coming to its advantages also. So if we talk about the principal component analysis, it is a technique that is used to emphasize variation and bring out the strong patterns in a data sheet. So to figure out, or you can say to make out some strong patterns in a data bundle, or you can say data sheet, we normally use a technique that is called principal component analysis. Why we use it? Because it makes data easy to explore and visualize. So with the help of principal component analysis, we can easily explore and visualize data bundle, or you can say a data sheet, or you can say a large amount of data. A good example of it is cloud computing. When we use cloud, or you can say when we need to access our data that is present in cloud, so that is very, very complex. So we normally use principal component analysis to go through it, or you can say to perform some kind of search, or to figure out some patterns, or to take out some things. We generally prefer principal component analysis. Why I will be coming to it. First, let's come on to a 2D, then we'll be talking about a 3D example also. So here's the data sheet you can see of 2D example. So it is a data points we are having, and this is the basically layout. Then if we use a principal component analysis on it, then it will become like this. We just change the orientation, or you can see that it is multi-dimensional, right? We just convert it into a one-dimensional view so that we can analyze it on the same line, or you can say same aspect, or you can say it gives us a better view. So that's why we use a principal component analysis. And when we come to the 3D example of it, as you can see like this, then this is one line, this is one line, this is the one line you can't see. I guess you can see the blue line over there, blue arrow over there. So same thing we do in 3D also. We just orient it, or we can say we just align it with the corresponding axis, and then we get a better 3D example, or you can say better 3D view of a data sheet. So that's why it is so much preferred in principal component analysis. Now if you want to write an example, you can just draw this diagram. You have to show that the orientation of it is in multi-dimensional space. With the help of principal component analysis, it is just made one directional, so that it can be easily accessed and easily explored. Then same thing is applied in 3D also. In 3D also, like a good example of it is cloud, where data is in abundance. Then we just align it in a three-dimensional space, or in a one-dimensional space, so for a better view or so better analysis of the data. So let's come on the advantages. So if we talk about the advantages of it, the first main advantage is PCA is useful tool for analyzing data, since patterns are difficult to identify in a high dimension. So because it is difficult to analyze patterns in a higher dimensional, we use PCA that identifies patterns of data, and data can be compressed to lower dimensional without significant loss of information. So without a PCA, you can say very less information is lost and data is converted into its lower dimensional that can be easily analyzed. So this was all about PCA. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.